Hello, welcome to today's class, and today we are going to see about Bayesian hierarchical clustering. And we already know about what is hierarchical clustering, and there are two types, which is agglomerative and divisive. Agglomerative is a bottom-up approach and divisive is a top-down approach. Whenever we talk about hierarchical clustering, there are two important terminologies. As how do you form clusters, okay? Either you start from each data set or each data point considered as a cluster, and then you start grouping them until you arrive at a single big cluster. That is one type, which is your agglomerative clustering. And there is a divisive, where you have one big cluster and you start breaking down till you end up with each data set becoming a single cluster. So that is the basic concept behind your hierarchical clustering and the types which we have as agglomerative or divisive. And when we do this, how do you define that which clusters are to be grouped together? So in that you have two terminologies about distance as well as the linkage. Linkage we've already seen. And with respect to distance, there are two basic types, which is Euclidean and Manhattan. And then in linkage, how do you find the distance between two different clusters, right? So there are four varieties which we have seen till now. One is single or complete linkage. Single works with minimum distance calculation. And complete linkage works with the maximum distance between data points between two clusters. And then you have the average, which works on the average of the every cluster with respect to the other cluster. And then you have this centroid, and then your wards linkage. Okay, these are the ones which we've already seen. What we have done till now is we did a recap, okay, and now we are going to see what is a Bayesian hierarchical clustering. So if you have understood whatever I spoke 2 minutes back, right, so that gives you a base to understand Bayesian hierarchical clustering. So what we used in agglomerative clustering, which is called as a variety and a hierarchical, so they usually call it as HAC, okay. So they usually say it as HAC, which is hierarchical agglomerative clustering. So in this, in order to calculate distance, they were using either Euclidean or Manhattan. Okay, so this was the two distance metrics which were used. But here, instead of these two, which is Euclidean and Manhattan, if you go for a probabilistic distribution, okay. If you go for probabilistic distribution in order to calculate your distance, okay, to help you to decide which clusters are to be grouped, and then you go along, okay. If you replace instead of this with this, then it forms your Bayesian hierarchy clustering, and the probabilistic distribution I use is Bayesian, okay. So otherwise your HAC is same as your BHC. Okay, got it? So that is the basic introduction. So now whatever I spoke, I've just wanted to show you. So look at this A, B, C, D and E, and these are the closest points. Okay, so I grouped this as one, and then C, D as second cluster, and then this becomes my third, and this becomes my fourth, which is your top, right? So this is one, and this is two, this is three, and this is four. So what have I done now is your agglomerative clustering, or it is called bottom to top, okay. And now as I already told you, the formula for your agglomerative clustering, so we were using this Manhattan and Euclidean, right? So Manhattan, just to recollect, so if there are two points A, B and C, D, and you want to calculate the distance between them, so you can use Manhattan or Euclidean. Manhattan is, this is the formula, okay, absolute value of the difference between A and C, plus the absolute value of difference between B and D. So where the points are A, B and C, D. And Euclidean, it is like the square of the difference, summation of the square of difference, and then you do a square root of it. Then this becomes Euclidean. So you use this in order to calculate distance between the clusters and group them accordingly. But in BHC, which is your Bayesian hierarchy clustering, the concept we use is probability distribution. So this is the important point, okay, which differentiates your hierarchical agglomerative as well as probability distribution. And now what we'll do is we'll go into the details. So how the algorithm works, okay? So algorithm for the Bayesian hierarchical clustering. So let me assume that D is a data set which consists of points x1, x2 till xn. Either you notate it like this or you notate it like this. It is your choice, right? And then this is the data set where these are the data points inside the data set, right? So this is the starting point. And then what we assume in as usual your agglomerative, hierarchical agglomerative clustering, the same way you will do it here also. So every data point here, I would assume it as a cluster, right? So that's what we did. X1, X2 is a cluster. Each one is a cluster. And then whichever is near, you start grouping them. So that's how we did, right? So each of this point, just to introduce the terminology, this each of the data point is called as cluster. It is called a single cluster. It is also called as leaves. Okay. So I can say if each one of this is a cluster, then I say this is D1, this is D2, likewise. So I say D1, D2 till Dn, okay, will belong to my D, which is my master data set. Okay. So Di, where I is 1 to n, will belong to D. Okay, so this is the basic notation which we have. So having said this, what do we do is, as I told you can also refer this data point as leaf. These are different terminologies which you use, and we also say it is subtree. Why do I say subtree? So if you look at this, there are different terminologies they use here. Okay, so if you have n data points, right, then you will have n clusters because each data point is a cluster. And I can also say the n data points, I will consider it as n leaves. This is one leaf, this is one leaf till dn, okay, and n subtree. So this is one subtree and this is another subtree, right? So if I have di and dj, then there will be ti and tj. So if there are n data points, okay, then I can say you have n subtrees, or I can say you have n clusters, or I can say you have n leaves. So this is introduction to terminology. So now I can also say if I have di and dj, and this is the subtree ti and tj, so if they are nearer together, I can cluster them. And this forms dk. So dk is a summation of di and dj. That's what I've written here. Dk is a summation of di union dj. Similarly, I can also say tk is a union. Tk is a union of ti and tj, which are subtrees. Everything is the same. It means the same. Different terminologies. Okay. So with this, what we'll do, we'll have a break. And then we'll continue the next lecture in the next class. Thank you. Welcome back. We were seeing about the Bayesian hierarchical clustering, and we observed that the difference between the hierarchical agglomerative clustering and the Bayesian hierarchical clustering is with respect to the distance calculation matrix. So in HAC it uses Euclidean or Manhattan, but here it is going to use a probabilistic approach. Okay, that is the very important difference which you should remember. And now coming to BHC, BHC is based on two important hypotheses which we are going to see now. So there is H1 and H2 are the two hypotheses. So let's see what is H1. So H1 states that the all data elements belonging to the merge cluster DK. What does it mean? So when I have DI and DJ, which we already saw are the two points, and now I merge these two into a cluster called as DK. So they are saying, when will you merge DI and DJ, under what condition? That is what H1 is a hypothesis is going to explain to you. If you can correlate, this also can be equated to AB, which we saw in the first page. So we had this point A and B was merged to create a cluster, and then we had C and D, they were merged to create another cluster. So the idea is why you're not merging A and C, and why you're merging only AB, why you're merging only CD, okay, that is the idea, right? So it is either based on the distance matrix which we use, or here in Bayesian it is about the probabilistic model, okay? So the condition is this. So these two points, if you wanted to merge it into a cluster called as DK, then both these items should have same probabilistic distribution model. For example, if this uses a Gaussian model, okay, this also should follow the same probabilistic model. Or in other words, these two points should fall within the same distribution curve. Okay, so if you have, for example, I'm just saying, if this is your Gaussian normal distribution curve, so now if you take two data points, so you're allowed to merge these two data points if they fall within this curve. So one point is here and one point is here, then maybe you are not allowed to, because maybe it is from a very different distribution compared to this one. That is what they're trying to say. And it should also be independently generated, okay? It should be independently, each of this item, okay, should be independently generated and identical from the same probabilistic model. Okay, so that is what we saw. So this is hypothesis one. So let us do it in a little mathematical style. So now when I say probability of x given theta, so what I say theta are nothing but your hyperparameters, or in other words, we call them as features. Okay, for example, if you wanted to predict the salary of a person given an experience, okay, then on what parameters or on what features I am going to decide this? Am I going to have years of experience, or I'm going to have PhD completion, or what are the features which you're going to consider? So these are can be considered or notated as theta. I think you're clear, right? So theta is the parameters or the hyperparameters on which this variable will depend on. So the input variable will depend on, okay, so the input variable may depend on other features, okay. So given a variable x, what are all the parameters, okay, on which your input is dependent, okay? It depends on the application, right? So x is the input variable and the theta is the parameters on which this x is dependent upon. Okay, so now we represent this as P of x given theta. So now if I say xi, which means, for example, I is 1 and I is 2. Okay, so when will I merge these two points? Okay, so I will merge these two points when they all come from a single probabilistic model. So what we have written here is the mathematical notation for the hypothesis. Okay. So I think this is enough to understand about the hypothesis H1. So now we will go to a understanding of probabilistic model. First, you should understand what is the probabilistic model to understand that what do you mean by is coming from the same probabilistic model. So there are different types of probabilistic model. Gaussian distribution is one of them. Okay, Gaussian distribution is one of the probabilistic model. So how a Gaussian distribution will look like? It's a bell kind of curve which is drawn here. Okay, it could be the x and y can be of different parameters given, for example, I wanted to predict the salary given experience, or I wanted to find the grade of a student given marks. Okay, so depending on the application, this x and y varies, but how the curve will look like? So it will have this. And this is your mean point, which is mu, okay, and the width of the curve, okay, from the mean point. So this is called as your standard deviation. And now if you square this, then it becomes variance, okay. So now I would say this theta, which we were talking about, P of x given theta. So we are just detailing on this theta. So the theta is dependent on the mean and the variance. Alright, so that is what we are trying to explain here. And now this formula is the one which explains how do you know that this x1 and x2 belongs to the Bell distribution here. It is inside this. So how do you find that? So this is the formula which you'll use to find out that these two points are lying within the Bell curve, so you can go for the merging. Okay, so now so what does this say again? X is dependent on your mu and the sigma squared, which I say variance. All right, so it depends on the mu and the variance. So nothing much to detail on this formula. This is a formula which you will apply to find whether this x1 and x2 can be merged for the cluster formation. So that is the take home from this formula. And now what we saw was Gaussian distribution, which means this one curve, right? So now if you have many Bell curves overlapping each other, then we call that model as a Gaussian mixture model. Again, it is commonsensical. Whenever I have this overlapping, this red which you see, the red are the points of this curve, the blue are the points of this curve, and green are the points of this curve. But now this area may have the red and blue points overlapping, and here you may have the blue and the green points overlapping. So what does that mean? There can be, these are all data points, okay? Or I say each one is a cluster. So there is a possibility that this data point can either belong to this curve or can be considered in this curve, okay, which means I can either use it to create cluster 1 here, or I can use it to create a cluster 2, cluster 3 like this. So now what can be the example? The example can be, I would look at where it is more closely related, taking a data point. Okay, I will see to which place it is very closer. Depending on that, I either merge it to cluster 1 or cluster 2. Okay, it is like, for example, if you take this point, instead of going for this curve, okay, I would prefer to merge it to this cluster. Alright, so that is what this says. And now what indirectly it explains is, we have already seen the definition of soft clustering. What is soft clustering? If there is a possibility of one data point being in one or more cluster, then it is soft clustering. What is hard clustering? Hard clustering is somewhere where if a data point belongs to one cluster, I will not allow it or I will not consider it belonging to the next cluster. Then it is called hard. So visually, it is very clear that this is a soft clustering model. And the formula for mean and variance, just for the recollection, you all knew it. Just for the recollection, I have provided it here. And now coming to the hypothesis in a mathematical notation. So how do we say, given the hypothesis H1, what does the given hypothesis H1 say? The H1 hypothesis says you can merge a point D1 and D2 if they come from a same single probabilistic distribution model. Okay, so only then I will allow you to merge. So that is what this says. Given this condition, what are all the data points which can create DK? Okay, DK, for example, in our case, we saw DI and DJ mixed together. So probability of given H1, what is the probability of forming DK as a cluster? Okay, this is what we are interested. So what does it say? So this is dependent on two probabilities. Okay, the first probability is your DK itself, which is the cluster. So I also already told you the cluster which you're forming will depend on your mu and your sigma squared. So when I say mu and sigma squared, what is it represented? It is theta. So I'm saying the probability of forming a cluster will depend on your mu and the k. And now in turn, what mu and k will depend on? Mu and sigma squared in turn will be dependent on the beta. Okay, so the beta is something like your features. Okay, it is again in specific we'll say features, features or the hyperparameters. But here the feature or the hyperparameter for theta, in other words, what do you say is this? We say it is mu and the sigma squared are the parameters or features for DK. But for deciding theta, I use beta, which can be which can be represented as your hyperparameters of features. For example, it can be the occurrence of a word and how repetitive it is coming. So the frequency of something. So that can be considered as beta. So this is the formula which helps you to find your H1. So having understood this, now what we saw was it is dependent on the Bayesian probability, right? So it is based on the posterior Bayesian probability. So we already know what is Bayesian probability. We just going to apply this concept in order to calculate the distance whereby I'm going to merge the cluster, right? So now P of B given A, okay? Then we have this formula P of A, product of P of A and P of A given B divided by P of B. So how do we represent this? So P of A will be the prior probability and this one will be the maximum likelihood and this will be the evidence of data point. This is a known formula and now we have to apply this into our case. What is our case? Given a hypothesis H1, what is the probability that a decay is formed? All right. Which is calculated using the prior probability of H1 in our case. This is H1. Prior probability of H1 and this one is what is the probability of getting H1, of getting H1 such a way that you form DK. How much true it is, okay? Forming DI and DJ together into a cluster, okay, given this, what is the probability that this hypothesis is true? So, which is nothing but your maximum likelihood divided by which is your evidence of data point. What does this mean? This I will consider both H1 and H2. We have just seen H1 as of now, but this will be a joint consideration of H1 and H2. Okay. So, in other words, this is a formula which I will adopt in order to get the posterior probability distribution for my Bayesian hierarchical clustering. Okay, this is the crux. This is the crux formula. And now coming to H2, which is the hypothesis H2. We've seen H1, now it is H2. So H2, what does it say is it is 1 minus of H1. So that what it says. So H1 plus H2 together will form a probability 1. So, okay. So this is like what this H1 says, what is the condition to merge? And this says, what is the condition at which you should not merge something, right? So if you have the subset, okay, if you have the data subset, assume if it is DK, if it is formed from two or more clusters, then you should not consider them for pairing, for the cluster formation. So this is what it says. So given the condition H2, okay, what is the probabilities for DK? Then I say, if it is a subtree, it is a subtree saying, if you can remember this, it was like this, DI, DJ and you merge together to create DK and internally it is called as TI, TJ and merge together it is called as DK. Alright, so that is what is mentioned here. DI given TI, probability of DI given TI into probability of DJ, TJ, this one. Okay, that it is a subtree. So now it should not have more than one. If it is already having more than one cluster, then you should not consider them in pairing the next unit. If it is already having this, okay, so you should not pair it with this element. So that is what it says. So having said this, according to the Bayesian probability, which is given here, which is reiterated here, P of B of A, given with prior probability, maximum likelihood and the evidence. Given this, we are going to create it for our case. Okay. So let me notate it as pi k. Pi k is nothing but the prior probability that all the points in DK, which is in our case DI and GJ, what is the probability that they belong to the single cluster? So that is given by this. Okay. Pi k is equal to probability of H1 is the one which gives me conditions of what should be clustered, right? So that is why I'm saying H1K. And now what is the evidence? Evidence is the denominator, which you have to consider hypothesis 1 and hypothesis 2. And you know what is hypothesis 1? Hypothesis 1 is this, if this is the probability pi k, and this should be 1 minus pi k. Okay? So putting it together, it will become 1. All right. So probability of dk given h1, k which is my hypothesis 1, which we already know how to do it, plus this formula we have already seen, p of di ti into probability of dj tj. What is the probability? Is 1 minus pi k. So this together will give me the denominator. I'm sorry, which will give me the denominator, which is pp, right? So let's do the final conclusion. So this is what I was interested in. I have to calculate this formula, which is the posterior probability rk, okay, by which I decide whether they come from the same probabilistic distribution model so that I can merge. Okay, so I'm just drawing the conclusion story. So now rk is given by pi k, which is nothing but your prior probability distribution, into p of dk given h1k, which is your maximum likelihood, divided by p of dk by tk. Okay, dk by tk is what we already saw here, which is the evidence. Okay, prior probability, maximum likelihood with respect to, divided by the evidence. And now what is prior probability? Prior probability is with, this is with respect to h1. If you say 1 minus, it is with respect to h2. And this one, what is the probability of dk getting merged into a cluster, given the condition is true, which is h1, divided by both of the cases of h1 and h2. Okay, so this is the formula. After you substitute all the values, okay, the conclusion is this: if your rk is getting a value greater than or equal to 0.5, then those two items can be merged and you can create a small cluster. So if there are two data points di and dj which can be merged, so how do you infer? You will get rk greater than or equal to 0.5. then it means those two points di and dj can be formed into a cluster. Okay, this brings us to the end of the class of hierarchical Bayesian hierarchical clustering, or HPC. Okay, hierarchical Bayesian clustering. So this is about the algorithm. What you can do is you can go back, try to substitute some values onto it, and you can also try writing a Python code or use inbuilt libraries. Okay, so thank you. We'll meet in the next class.